Just want to congratulate you on your upcoming wedding. Super excited for you. I shot a note out to my parents and my sister and my grandma, who've all sort of been married for 10 plus, 30 plus, 40 years. And they had a couple pieces of advice. So number one is never go to bed angry. Make sure you hash everything out before you guys fall asleep. My grandma said to never embarrass your husband in public and not talk about what happens in the bedroom publicly. And my parents said when you fight, just remember it's not really worth getting mad about. So hope that is some good guiding advice for you as you start this new chapter.
Congrats, Priscilla and Daniel. I've only been married for 2 years. I don't think I can give you really great advice on married life, but I once got this advice from somebody who has been married for close to 30, 40 years, and I found it really useful. Just remember that there may be many things you find cute about your other half now, but many years later, those same things you may find really irritating. So when that happens, look back, remember why you fell in love, and remember what you found cute about the other person, and get back in love. So all the best and enjoy the rest of your lives together.
Hey, Priscilla, it is John. Congratulations. Just some advice for me. Actually, this is not advice for you, it's advice for Daniel. Daniel, one thing to remember: happy wife, happy life. It's that easy.
Hi, Priscilla. Congratulations on your wedding. I can't wait to hear how all the festivities go in Hawaii. And I wanted to let you know that Daniel is a very lucky guy to be marrying someone so smart and kind and funny and pretty and who has such great restaurant recommendations, who I always enjoy having dinner with. And just wanted to let you know that the Bev office has not been the same since you moved to the Bay Area, but we know that you're enjoying the next phase of your life with Daniel, so we're very happy for you and wish you all the best and hope you have a wonderful wedding.
Hi, Priscilla. Just wanted to say congratulations. You and I have talked a lot about your upcoming wedding, and I just want to remind you about our conversation where I advise you to make sure you have a great time. This is your day, it's the only day you'll ever get. I hate to say, but it's true. But also wanted to remind you that amidst all the chaos of work and mortgages and kids, don't forget about your husband because he is the glue that holds your family together. All the best. I miss you already and have a great time. And again, congratulations.
Yeah, girl. Congratulations, Priscilla. Have a great wedding. Mwah.
Yeah,
perfect.
Perfect.
Perfect. Is it on? Are we gonna edit this?
No.
Oh, it's been on the whole time.
Okay. Priscilla, I have sat next to you for a year now, literally like at the same desk. So I feel like I probably should have been invited, but it's okay. It's okay. Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. Anyway, point is this. I wish you all the happiness in the world. You deserve it. You're the best. I'm so sorry you moved away. But hopefully we'll see you soon. You'll visit us. All the best to you guys. Cheers from Scotland.
That was funny. The light in the background?
Well, the light's amazing.
Daniel, treat Priscilla like the queen that she is. That's it.
Hey, Priscilla, congratulations on the wedding. We're supposed to give you some advice, so I have two very important things to tell you. Number one, make sure you marry someone who cooks. From our conversations yesterday, it sounds like you've already taken care of that, which is great. Number two, on the wedding weekend, make sure you take care of yourself. Go for a run, bike, swim, yoga, meditate, journal, whatever you need to do to feel centered. It'll make you feel beautiful, it'll make the weekend so special, and it will be worth it. Congratulations again.
Congratulations, Priscilla and Daniel. Fun times are ahead. As someone in their 15th year of marriage, I just want to tell you that every year it gets better, and if it doesn't, you're doing it wrong. I'm sure you guys will do great, and lots and lots of best wishes for the future. Congratulations.
Hi, Priscilla and Daniel. Congratulations on your wedding day and your marriage. Aaron here, and this is John. And we wanted to make this video to wish you the best of luck and well wishes. John and I are not married, so we don't feel like we could give you any sort of wedding or marriage advice. But what we can do is take you through a YouTube channel scorecard and what we think will help you get through life, your day-to-day life in your marriage. So we're going to take you through that right now.
So using the tenets of the scorecard is, number one, captivate your audience. So in a marriage, you know, you always want to make sure you're engaging each other and doing cool stuff.
Number two is calls to action. Make sure you guys are communicating, calling each other, letting each other know what's happening.
Regular schedule and frequency. You want to make sure that you're transparent about when you're going to be there, stuff that you're going to do together, just like you're programming a YouTube channel.
Playlists. When you guys are having dinner parties and people over, it's super important to agree what kind of music you're going to put in the playlist prior to the party.
Tempo programming, holidays, Olympics, sporting events. Just make sure that you plan your calendar out really far in advance.
YouTube Live. I don't know, Daniel, if you've heard that we just launched YouTube Mobile Live. You guys should definitely take advantage of it and let us know how your life is going.
Okay. Channel optimization, metadata, thumbnails, and you guys got that. You guys got the metadata. You could hire a service provider to do that. I think you got it.
Build your community. Really take advantage of each other's friends and groups of friends and all hang. Like, your friends can get with our friends and then we can all be friends.
And then finally, for your community, collaboration. Marriage is a collaboration, so make sure it's a partnership and you're cross-promoting to each other's channel or collaborating.
And last but not least, is probably most important and relevant to you, is blog outreach.
Blog outreach.
If you don't know what to say, just go to Google.
Yeah,
and Google
blogs.
Blogs about marriage.
The blog. So we give you guys all greens, all great on the channel scorecard, and wish you the best in your marriage.
Bye.
Hey, Priscilla. Hey, Dan. It's Veda here. Congratulations on your wedding. I hope you're very happy together and that you achieve greatness in life as a team. As for the advice piece, Priscilla, for you, I'd recommend that you try to always remember the qualities that made you fall in love for Dan and stick with them. So whether you're going through good or bad, always look at him through the lens of the person who you fell in love with. Whether it's funny or sweet or geeky, whatever his side is that you like the most, cherish it and always remember about it. And for you, Dan, very simple advice. Whenever you guys have an argument, Priscilla will always win. Be happy, you both. Bye.
Congratulations, Priscilla. I wish you all the best. I hope you have a great honeymoon, and here's to many years of happiness.
Two, one.
Hey, Priscilla and Daniel. I'm so happy for you, and I think in this video, I'm supposed to give some advice. And my advice is going to actually be the non-advice advice. Marriage is so much like jazz music. Sometimes you can't think about it. You have to do it. You have to allow the improv to happen, the harmony to happen. Sometimes you'll have dissonance, but then you'll bring it back to that harmony. You'll have solos and you'll bring it back to that harmony. Marriage is so much like that. At least it has been for me, and I hope you enjoy your jazz music. Do 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 do. Bye.